मन्दे वाञ्छितलाभाय कर्म किं तन्न कथ्यते किं दम्पतिमिति ब्रूयाम् उदाहो दम्पति इति वी स्टॉप्ड विद हाउ वाय द देवास् अस्त्रास् ऑफ देवास् आर् ऑल् निष्फलम् देर् इस् नो एफेक्ट् फार् देम् इट् इस् बिकम् दे बिकेम् वेरि इन्एफेक्टिव् इन् द सेन्स् बिकास् दि अधिष्ठातृ देवतास् आर् देम्सेल्व्स् बीङ्ग् डिफीटेड् So they are unable to provide any effect for the astras that the devas are using, right? So vayu arka chakra varunanala devatani api astrani nirjara varaihi abhimantritani isham babuvur asureshu na shasanani rajyachyutasya nrupateriva nagareshu. Just like a king who is no longer in the position of authority, his orders are no longer effective among the citizens. In the same way, the astras were also rendered ineffective. Now, the next shloka, what is the state in which the devas were? He compares it and says in the shloka, they are being hit by the wind, just the wind that comes from the arrows. So the asuras are all sending arrows, and before the arrows can even hit, they are hit by the wind that the arrows are generating. And when they are being hit by that wind, they remember the pralaya kala and think that even the pralaya kalam is much better than this state. That is the manasthiti in which they are. Danuja bhuja
vikrishta kodanda दण्डोप सम्पातुक ज्वल धनल दुराप आराच धारा समीराहताः युग विगम समुच्छलत चण्ड चण्डीश भूष भूषोरग प्रतिभ प्रतिभयमुख वातजातां दशा
उज्जगुः
दशाम् उज्जगुः निर्जराः
निर्जराः दशाम् उज्जगुः उज्जगुः मीन्स् दे वर् प्रेसिङ्ग् दट् स्टेट् सो लेट्स् गो वित् हौ दे आर् इन् फस्ट् सो निर्जराः दि एड्जेक्टिव् हि गिव्स् इस् द फस्ट् एण्टैर् पादम् ధనుజ భుజ వికృష్ట కోదండ దండ ఉపసంపాతుక జ్వల దనల దురాప నారాచ ధారా సమీర ఆహతాః నారాచ ధారా సమీప ఆహతాః సమీర ఆహతాః సమీర విండ్ సో దే ఆర్ బీయింగ్ హిట్ బై ద విండ్ దట్ కమ్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ద నారాచ ధారా నారాచః it's a very funny word. I don't remember if interesting word that I don't remember if I told you the vyutpatti for the word naracham. Narachaha is banaha. Naram or naranam samuhaha is naram. Narana achamanam karoti. It drinks the lives of people. That is why the bana is called narachaha. So naracha dara, the flow or the rain of arrows, as they are being sent by the asuras, a wind arises from that. So the force with which an object flies, there is also a small air pocket that comes, right, and hits them. So naracha dara samira ahataha. How is that? Jwalat anala, danuja bhuja vikrishta. Kodanda, danda, Danuja are asuras. Danuja bhujaihi vikrishtasya kodanda dandasya. Vikrishta is pulled. The bow is being pulled by the asuras. So danuja bhujaihi vikrishtaha kodanda dandaha. Kodanda dandasya samipe. Now those arrows are being sent with agni, or due to friction, sometimes when the arrow flies through the air, there is a friction and there is agni with it. So jvalat danda upasampatuka is samipa, samipavarti. So near that bow, the asura's bow, you find a jwalat anala. A fire is burning, and that fire is durapaha. Because of that fire, or you can say, you can say that the bows are resembling a fire which cannot be crossed. You can either say jwalat anala durapaha narachaha, in the sense the fire is there, physical fire is present, or you can say jwalat analaha eva durapaha narachaha. Just like how a fire is burning and you cannot cross it, in the same way this arrow was also difficult to conquer. That sort of an arrow the asuras were sending forth. So jwalat anala durapa naracha dhara dharayaha samipena samirena ahataha. Keep thinking, looking at that word and say samipa. Samirena ahataha amaraha nirjaraha. The word here is being used as nirjara, the one who don't have any old age. So nirjaraha. Dasham ujjaguhu, they praised the state in which they usually are during the pralayakalam. How is that pralayakalam? So in the pralayakalam, yuga vigama, at that point of time Shiva is dancing tandava, right? When you get time, just read through that Tandava Stotram that is there. You might find it online somewhere. Very beautiful rhythm the Stotram has for it. Yes. Ravana Krita Tandava Stotram. Yes. Chakara Chanda Tandavam Tanotana Shiva Shiva. Beautiful piece. Just to read it, it has a very nice feel. So yuga vigama samaye samuchalat prarabdham chanda chandisha tandavam, that which has been started. Now tandavam is not mentioned there, so samuchalat is just moving. It's a very very small word, so that is why I like the word tandavam here instead of that. So yuga vigama samaye chanda chandishena kritam tandavam. At that point of time, the snakes that are there on Shiva, they are all very troubled by the dance that Shiva is dancing. So natural, right? Imagine the state, the whole entire world is shaking and the pralaya is happening. So how would the snakes on Shiva's body, which are like an alankara for him, Chandisha Bhusha, the alankaras of Shiva, namely Uraga, the snakes, pratibhaya mukha vata jatam. They are letting out sighs because they are unable to tolerate the state in which they are. So they are sighing constantly or breathing, or they are out of breath. Pratibhaya mukha, pratibhaya bhayankara. Bhayankara mukha vata jatam. It is like they are being hit by a wind, which is similar to the wind that comes out, or the breath of the snakes that come out at the time of that pralayakala dance, tandava. Tadrisha dasham ujjaguhu. They were praising even that. If they had stood in front of those snakes when Shiva was dancing, because all the devas were watching when he was doing the tandava, right? And when they were watching, these snakes were out of breath, or they were breathing with a great force, and the air that came out of their mouths were very difficult to face. And even that is much better than the state at which they are now. The difference is, see, that is a very happy occasion, in the sense they are viewing Chandisha Tandava. What great grace can there be beyond this, right? It is their fortune that they are being able to witness that dance, right? Whereas here, it is a very shameful state in which they are. They are being hit by the asuras. So they say that the other state is much better. Pralayakala state is so much better than this, right? So ujjaguhu. Okay. I didn't think of it that way. So this mukhavata jatam is again, because of the samasa construct, it is very difficult to understand that again. So the uraganam pratibhaya bhayankara mukavatehi jatam dasham. The state in which they are put because of the breaths that come out of the snake. Okay, you have a doubt?
So now are the devatas thinking like this, that you know, are they praising that pralaya kala samaya? They are amongst themselves, they are thinking.
Yeah, they were praising that state. Yes, so you know, it is so much better that we are being hit, if we were hit by that wind during the pralaya kala. This is because they are getting defeated here, right? So this situation is worse than that. During pralaya kala, even if they are being hit by that wind and they are suffering, it is still in a way, it is a joyous occasion, in the sense they could witness the gods dance. All these are just dvani. It is not written here. You have to understand all that. No, how much you can get to see, dvani is something which is suggested, which is not written in words by the poet, right? That is what I'm trying to explain here. So they praised that state. That is all is given here. Why should they praise a pralaya kalam state when here they are only being defeated in the war? They are not being killed as such, right? They don't have a death unless it is if their work is finished. See, these are all ajanma devaha who are born as a deva, and they will stay or remain as devas until their work is finished. So their sthiti is there till pralaya. They cannot die before that. Okay. So they are only being defeated. There is a chance that they will come back. Right?
Yeah.
So that is why they are saying the samira ahataha devaha pratibhaya mukha vata jatam dasham ujjaguhu. They said even the pralaya kala samira is much better than this samira. So what could be the reason for it? That is suggested. That is left to the mind of the reader. So here there is a vyatireka alankaram where they are praising the uraga mukha vata dasham prashamsanti. So it is better than the samira, the danuja samira, right? Danuja bana samira at uraga mukha vataha vyatiriktaha. Or it is better, utkrishtaha, that is why. So if you show a difference between the upamana and the upameya and show that one is better, then that is vyatireka alankara. Next, of course, it is equal to that is upama dhvani. More than the upama dhvani, I think it is the lajja that they feel as to being defeated is also a dhvani here, which is a vastu dhvani. So danuja bhuja vikrishta kodanda danda upasampatuka jvaladanala durapa naracha dhara samirahataha yuga vigama samuchalat chanda chandisha bhusha uraga pratibhaya mukhavata jatam dasham ujjaguhu nirjaraha ujjaguhu udgiyanti udgiyate or udgayanti, in the sense they are praising, they sing the praises of that dasha.
படிக்கிறது கஷ்டமா இருக்கு.
ஆமா, லெட்ஸ் புதுசு புதுசா இருக்கு விருத்தம், எனக்கு சொல்ல தெரியல.
ஆல்சோ ஓகே, ரெண்டாவது கேள்வி நாட் சந்தஸ் ரிலேட்டட் ஆக்சுவலி. இது வந்து உத்தம துவனி ஸ்லோகமா இல்ல குணிபூத துவனியா?
குணிபூதம் இன் தி சென்ஸ் because you have the adena dvani avada the id is
dasham
dasham mukhavata jatam dasham ujjaguhu, that description is much more beautiful than the fact that they were ashamed. So the vachyam is more beautiful than the vyangya. There is no beauty in saying that uragavatam ashnanti banaha api devanam pranamayam ashnanti. Idla onnu periya chamatkaram illa unakku. Not much of a that upama dhvani is also, and vastu dhvani if you take both, or bhava dhvani lajja angra bhava dhvani arundalo, it's not as beautiful as the it. So it's a guni bhuta vyangya.
Okay,
இட்ஸ் எ குட் ஸ்லோகம். அதுக்காக ஜஸ்ட் பிகாஸ் குணீபூத வேங்கே பட் இட்ஸ் நாட் அ நைஸ் வன்.
ஓகே
ஓகே தனுஜ புஜ விகிருஷ்ட கோதண்ட தண்டோபசம்பாதுக ஜலதனல துராப நாராஜ தாரா சமீராஹதாஹ யுக விகம சமுச்சல சண்ட சண்டீஷ பூஷோரக பிரதிபய முகவாத ஜாதாம் தசாம் உச்சகுர் நிர்ஜராஹ. நவ் தே ஆர் டிஸ்கிரைபிங் த டிஃபரெண்ட் பாக்கெட்ஸ் ஆஃப் பீப்புள். ஒன் இஸ் வருணா, ஹவு ஹி வாஸ் கம்ப்ளீட்லி நியூட்ரல் ஆஸ் இஃப் நத்திங் இஸ் ஹி டிட் நோ வாட் டு டூ. So Varuna's plight is described. The next is about the Karma Deva, those who have performed different karmas and come to Swargam. We talked about this Ajana Deva and Karma Deva distinction in the beginning itself when we were looking at Amaravati description. Ajana Devaha or Ajanma Devaha, those who are Devas by birth, and Karma Devaha are those who have performed certain actions and they have come here. So the moment their karma phalan is gone, and then they will go down to bhumi to perform again, right? So their sthiti, and then at the end, the next portion is about the asuras who have become devas. See, asuras also, when they die in the war, they can become devas, right? So how, what is the vyavahara of them? How do they perform? What are they doing at this point of time in the battlefield?
சநீடம் ஆகந்தும் அநீஹமானேஷு ச யாதோகணேஷு ஸ்வாத்ம ஏக ஏகசேஷதயா பக்னசேதாஹ பிரசேதாஹ பிராக்ருத லோக சாதாரணஹ தடஸ்தஹ ஏவ பஹிஹி அவதஸ்தே.
ததஹ பிரசண்டே பவமானே வலதி சதி, when a great wind, unbearable wind was flowing, blowing, and then when this பிரச்சண்டே பவமானே வலதி சதி is about the தனுஜ நாராஜ சமீர. It is not our Vayu he is talking about, okay? Or it can also be Vayu, because he is going to describe Vayu's state, what happened later. Then you will understand why I say it could be Vayu also. But it is, as of now, because of the context, we are only talking about the wind that comes from the arrows sent by the asuras. So tataha, then pavamane, prachande pavamane, a great wind was valati sati, was blowing at that point of time. Varidhareshu tulavat duratayeva utsaryamaneshu, varidharati iti varidharaha meghaha, megheshu tulavat utsaryamaneshu satsu. When the winds, when the clouds were being utsaryamana, utsaryamana swept away, like as if with a broom you're sweeping, right? So varidhareshu, varidharaha utsaryamanaha bhavanti, katham tulavat, tulaha, tulam is karpasa, cotton. Like cotton, these clouds were all being swept away further, durata eva, away, far away. Sagaranapi shoshayataha tasya sanidam agantum anihamaneshu cha yadoganeshu. Now Yadogana is we are talking about Varuna here, right? So who is Varuna's friends or his family or people who surround him are animals which live in the fish and all that, right? The aquatic animals, that is Yadogana. Yadas are fish, great fish which live in the ocean. The Timingalam Madri, Priya Priya, shark and whale and all that. Those are his allies or his friends. So those Yadoganeshu, Yadoganani, Aganaha, Sagarana Soshayataha, Tasya Samipam Api Agantum. Sanidam is Samipam. Nideyeva Saha Vartate Iti, Sahavasaha Kriyate. So Nideyeva, in the sense they are all from birds of the same feather, right? They live in the same nest, which means Samipam. This wind was trying to dry up the entire ocean, even all the oceans, it was trying to dry it up. So Sagaran api Shoshayataha tasya Shoshayanna Shoshayataha sixth case there. Shashti Vibhakti. So Shoshayataha tasya pavamanasya, when that wind was trying to dry up all the oceans, and these Yadav Ganeshu, the aquatic animals did not want to, anihamanaha, anichantaha. So they did not want to even come near Sanidamapi Agantum, Tasya Samipamapi Agantum, Pavamanasya Samipamapi Agantum, Na Ichanti Yadav Ganaha. So as a result, Yadav Ganeshu, Anihamaneshu Satsu, when this was happening, what happened? Prachetaha, Bhagnachetaha, he was very depressed because of that. And Swatma Ekasheshataya, only himself, he alone was remaining there. Because of the reason, because of that solitude, Prachetaha Varuna was Bhagnachetaha, he became very upset and depressed. So when a person is feeling very alone, what do they do? Prakrita Loka Sadharanaha. Tatastaha eva. So immediately they'll go out, right? When someone is feeling very depressed, in a group of, when there are a lot of people and you are being ostracized, then you feel alone and you stand outside, right? That is what happens here. So you take up a neutral position and you don't say, neither do you say, I like the devas, nor do you say that I like the asuras. So that is the state of Varuna at that point of time. Prakrita loka sadharanaha. Prakrita loka, normal people. An action which is very normal to the people of the world. Prakrita loka sadharanaha samanaha. Eva, as if he is equal to a normal person, tatastaha eva, in a neutral position, bahihi atishtat, bahihi avatasthe, he stood outside. Outside in the sense, outside of the battlefield. He did not get into the kalathala yarangala. He did not get into the battle and fight. He just stood neutral because none of his friends wanted to come near him to fight. See, his army will be only those aquatic animals, right? So those, they did not even want to come near because the wind was trying to dry up the ocean. So their very existence was at stake here. So they did not want to be with Varuna and support him. Okay. Next is the Karma Deva.
Apicha Ripu Chamu Samuha Samut Srujyamana Shara Varsha Dharshiteshu Varmasu Bhidyamaneshu Charmasu Karma Devaha Kasmat Ayam Asmakam Akasmiko Buddhi Viparyayaha Kasmai Vayam Asuraihi Yudhyamahe Kasya Hetoho Vadhyamahe Buddhyamahe Na Hetum Asmin Ayase Keno Devaha, Kecha no Danavaha, Samabhritya Tapamsi Duscharani, Samprapta Vayam Amarapadam, Kena Shakya Nigrahitum, Kena Shakya Anugrahitum, Adishthasyati Yaha Swargam, Atitayaha Tasya Vayam Bhavama, Iti Kritanishchayaha, Sammantriya Parasparam, Sanghashaha apa chakramuhu samantataha api samara mukhat.
Ha, Kritanischayaha, they made a big decision now. Sammantriya parasparam, they spoke to each other, consulted with each other. Sanghashaha, in groups or in hordes. Samara mukhat, from the battlefield. Samantataha api, all round, they just apachakramuhu, they moved away. Whether they were on the north or south or east or west, wherever they were, they just consulted among each other, and in hordes and in groups, they just moved away. They did not want to stay there. Why? What was the decision that they made, and what was the state in which they were when they made this state? They looked around them. Ripu Chamu Samuha, the enemy army, the groups of enemy armies that were there, taihi samuhaihi samutsrijyamana, the arrows were being released, right? Samutsrijyamana sharaha charanam varsha. So the rain of arrows that was being released by the asura enemy army groups, what did those arrows do? Varmasu dharshiteshu satsu. Varma is their kanchuka armor. The armors were being dharshita, hit by the arrows. That is the first one. And then it not only stopped with hitting the armor, it also went and hit the skin beneath it. So vidyamaneshu charmasu. There is another reading where he says it is vidyamaneshu marmasu is also taken here. So if it is marma, it goes and hits until the joints or insides, the vital organs is marma. Marmasu vidyamaneshu satsu. Even when the marma or the vital organs are being hit, not only is the armor being hit, charma means skin. The skin is also being attacked. Or you can say that their marmasu vidyamaneshu satsu, even the vital organs are being hit at that point of time. Karma devaha, those who have become devas because of the yaga and yajna that they have performed every day, and they have attained that devatvam. What do they say? No, why do we have to? No, what is this change of intelligence that we have? See, we should try to analyze the situation and say, this is not of any use to us. We have an expression in Tamil where we say, Rama anda enna, Ravana anda enna, namak aathla velai aganomba. It doesn't matter who is ruling the country, whether it is Rama or Ravana, we have to keep on performing our work. We are, after all, guests in this country. That's a nice expression, and that is the expression that he beautifully reflects here, the way they think. So it doesn't matter whoever it was, even during freedom fighting in when it was happening in India, it's a common insult or a common thing that they talk about Brahmins is they were the first people who moved their allegiance from the kings to the Britishers. It's a very common that they talk about, fault of the Brahmins that they talk about. So not only Brahmins in the sense, I would say people who are more worried about something beyond let's say not fighting or anything, they are only worried about their duty that they have to perform every day. As long as that is not getting affected, they will continue doing their work. It's also a slight remark on that, I feel, that they don't involve themselves or in anything, any war, they don't take sides, there is no patriotism, all that you can understand from that. So kasmat ayam asmakam akasmikaha buddhi viparyayaha. Akasmikaha, a sudden buddhi viparyayaha, change of buddhi. Why should we fight now? That is that change of buddhi. Why did we start fighting like this when we are being hit in such a manner? Suddenly they change their mind at that point of time. So kasmat, for what reason, ayam asmakam akasmikaha buddhi viparyayaha, this change of buddhi for us. Kasmai vayam asuraihi yudhyamahe. Kasmai, for what reason are we fighting with these asuras? Kasya hetoho vadyamahe, for what reason are we killing people? Budhyamahe na hetum asmin ayase, in this effort, I don't understand the reason for it. Hetum na budhyamahe, I don't see any reason for this. Keno devaha naha, for us, who are these devas and who are the asuras? Kenocha danavaha kecha naha danavaha. They are not relatives to us. The devas are not related to us. The danavas, that is the asuras, are also not related to us. Who are they for us? Why should we fight for this? Sambhritya tapamsi duscharani tapamsi sambhritya. we have collected, that is, we have performed difficult, dus charani, dukhena charaha, very difficult to perform tapas. All those tapas we have collected, samvritya, sampraptaha vayam amarapadam. We have come to this deva, devatvam, or we have attained this amarapada, this position of a deva, because we have performed tapas for a long time and collected that good merit and come here. Kena shakya anugrahitum, kena shakya anugrahitum. So we, it's also a thing that they have to believe in only the karma that they have done. So nobody can either bless them or control them. They are free in the manner that they are not dependent on somebody else, like the Ajana Devaha. It is their duty to fight or protect that city. That is their duty. Whereas Karmadeva, all they have to do is tapas. That is all they have to do. Their duty. So, kena nigrahitum shakya? How can they be controlled by someone else or imprisoned by someone else? Nobody can do that. Kena va shakya anugrahitum? Nobody blesses them as such. Anugraha, they don't give any anugraham for them, especially because they are Karmadeva. No, no. They perform their duty. They come here, they enjoy the comforts, go back. That's all. So, it's like a guest. So, yaha swargam adhishtasyati, the one who is in an adhikara position at swarga, tasya vayam atidayaha bhavamaha. We will just remain as guests to that person who rules the swarga. Idi kritanaschayaha. So they made such a decision and consulted amongst each other and left the battlefield. Not cowardice. It's more, people might say that it is cowardice, but I also feel it shows the importance of karma there. Performing karma, performing your duty is absolutely necessary here. It is not their duty to fight. Their duty is only defined by what they do in the bhumi. So they do something in the bhumi, they come here, they are here only to enjoy. That is all they have to do. And the moment their punya comes down, they'll have to come back to the bhumi to perform the yagas and do their duty again. That is all. So in that sense, they are doing the sixth type of work that is defined for a Brahmin. Vyajanam, Vyajanam, Adhyayanam, Adhyapanam, Dana, Pratigraha. These are the six type of work that they have to do. That is the duty enjoined to them in this bhumi. And then they come to this swarga to just enjoy. That's all. Okay? So fighting is never in their work. Next is the set of devas, that is the asura who have become deva. I told you about how if you die in the battlefield, you become a deva, you attain viraswarga. Yet they still have that thought that they are asura. They were asuras. So how do they behave? They behave like spies here for the asuras. And the, other than the ullukulla kooda irundhu kuli parikkiradilla, adhudhaan. That is, you stay with them and from the inside you destroy the whole thing, right? That is what they are doing here.
Atha ye kechit ahava mukhe huta shariraha danava viraha deva bhavam apadya divam arudhaha nigudha abhisandhyaha te kila sahridaya iva kanchit kalam ahridaya eva parikramya parijnata marmanaha sarvataha nirvapayasu nirvapayamasuhu atti atarkitaha eva girvana balam.
So girvana balam nirvapayamasuhu. Nirvapayamasuhu usually is used when you extinguish a fire. If there is a small fire, then you extinguish it, you use the word nirvapayati. Here, what the girvana balam nirvapayamasuhu, they extinguished the army, deva's army, girvanaha deva, the deva's army, not extinguish. Here, what can be compared to a fire in the devas? It is the utsaha that is there in them. So they removed that enthusiasm that they could have for fighting. So they stayed inside. Ye kechithu, those, some of those who ahava muke at the battlefield, ahavaha yuddha, yuddha muke, huta shariraha, they sacrificed their own sharira, their bodies in the battlefield. Who are those people? Danava viraha, the courageous asuras. And then they got the deva bhavam apadya, devatvam praptaha, divam arudaha, swargam agataha, they came to swarga. Now what did they do? Niguda avisandayaha. Abhisandhi is abhipraya. Their abhipraya is tirohitam. They hide their true intentions. So what are their true intentions? They wanted to control the devas. You cannot change the swabhava of anybody. Even if, what is that in Manashaurya Paddhati? Even if a lion is very weak and its teeth are not functioning, it's not sharp enough, its nakha is not sharp enough, it will still want to get the mamsam of the elephant. So they cannot let go of their nature. It's very natural for them to hate the devas. So even if they have become deva bhavam apadya api, divam arudhaha api, niguda abhisandayaha te, they hide their intentions, true intentions, and what do? They roam around as if they are friends. Sahridayaha iva parikramya, sahridayaha samana hridayaha suhridaha iva kanchit kalam parikramya. Kintu ahridayaha eva, they don't have any hridayam. That is without any heart, in the sense they don't have any attachment to the devas that are there. So they are actually without a heart. They are very cruel. Ahridayaha, they are cruel without a heart. So hridaya rahitaha kruraha kanchit kalam sahridaya iva parikramya. They roam around as if they are friends. Parignyata marmanaha. So why do that? They want to know the secrets. Marma rahasyam. So parignyata rahasyaha sarvataha, everywhere, all round, atarkitaha eva, without getting revealed. Tarkita is tarkitam is you analyze and deduce. That is you think about whether this person could be your sahridaya or not, suhrit or ripu. All they don't reveal their intentions. So atarkitaha, they are not at all being analyzed by the devas as to their true intentions. So without getting noticed, atarkitaha, without getting noticed, girvana balam, the deva army, nirvapayamasuhu, they removed the enthusiasm that the deva army had and made them very depressed. Next, now when all this happened, the allies or in groups, see, you will know in times of trouble, you will know who is your friend and who is not your friend. So that is what is here. Varuna remained neutral. The Karma Deva all moved away because they said this is not our job. The Daitya Devaha, Asura Devaha, they were trying to bring down the morale of the army. Now, because of all these people, what is the state of the Devas? What were they doing?
Apasarataha Karma Devan, Abhignataha Daitya Devan, Apatataha Sharan, Ashi Vishan Iva Drishti Vishan, Utsarpataha Vishrunkhalam Asurabhatan, Ullanghita Velan Iva Kallolan Mada Mahadhadehe, Aprabhavataha Senapati.
It should be Mahodadehe.
Mahodadehe. Aprabhavataha senapatin apratipatti mudham api pashyantaha swaminam apashyantaha trataram.
The first few adjectives, if you see, all of those where the verb is there, the shanach pratyam is there, that is all in dvitiya bahuvachanam, dvitiya vibhakti bahuvachanam. So apasarataha karma devane பஷ்யந்தஹ வேர் யூ சி அப்ரதிபதி அப்ரதிபத்தி மூடம் அபி பஷ்யந்தஹ சுவாமினம் தட் பஷ்யந்தஹ இஸ் ஃபார் தேவாஹ இட் கோஸ் டு லெட் மீ சி வேர் இட் இஸ் விபுத பட்டாஹ த பேராகிராஃப் எண்ட்ஸ் வித் விபுத பட்டாஹ விஜகடிரே தே slipped and went away. They ran. So the devas ran. So vibhuda bhataha, everything is going to go as an adjective to vibhuda bhataha, the warriors. And what is the adjective here? Pashyantaha is the adjective. Whereas the whom are they seeing? They first looked at the karma devas moving away. Apasarataha karma devan, those karma devas who were stepping away. Daitya devan abhignantaha daitya devan pashyantaha, seeing the asura devaha who were killing, abhignantaha who were killing. And then ashi vishan iva drishti vishan sharan apatataha sharan pashyantaha, those arrows that were apatataha falling, those arrows that were approaching them. And how were they looking like? They were looking like ashi vishan iva, like serpents. Drishti vishan, which were like poison to the eyes. So the arrows were resembling snakes that were like that were drishti visha, poison to the eyes. Tadrisha sharan apatataha sharan, those agachataha sharan pashyantaha, those who were looking at it. Then utsarpataha vishrinkhalam விஷங்கலம் அசுரபட்டான் உத்சர்பதா அசுரபட்டான் பஷ்யந்தா, தே வர் லுக்கிங் அட் தி அசுரா சோல்ஜர்ஸ் ஹூ வர் மூவிங் உத்சர்பதா, தே வர் ரோமிங் அரவுண்ட் விஷங்கலம். ஷிருங்கலா இஸ் செயின்ஸ், அன்செயின்ட், அன்ஃபெட்டர்ட், ஸோ விதவுட் எனி கண்ட்ரோல், அன்கண்ட்ரோலபிளி தீஸ் அசுரா சோல்ஜர்ஸ் வர் ஆல் மூவிங் அரவுண்ட் உத்சர்பதா, ஜஸ்ட் லைக் ஹவு தி ஓஷன்ஸ் வேவ்ஸ் if they cross the vela is the border which they never cross, right? So mahodadehe kallolane ullangita velane kallolane iva, just like the oceans, the waves of the oceans which have crossed its limit or its border. Imagine a high tide and a constant high tide, so the ocean, there is never a check for the ocean and it is moving like that. In that manner, these asura soldiers were also moving unfettered or unchained. Aprabhavataha senapatin, these aprabhavataha prabhavati, prabhavaha is effect, without any effect these senapatis did not have any effect there. Senapati here are deva senapati, the sena deva senapatin aprabhavataha deva senapatin pashyantaha, the seeing the ineffective senapatis. Furthermore, their lord, that is Indra, how was he? He was just as if he was he could not move. Apratipatti moodham swaminam api pashyantaha, even their swami, lord, king, was apratipatti moodha. Pratipatti jnanam, he has no cognition of anything. He was such a moodha or a fool who did not cognize or understand what is going on in front of him. Tam swaminam pashyantaha, seeing him when their king was without any action or he was behaving like a fool, what did they also understand from that? Trataram apashyantaha, not seeing any protector. Trata is a protector, not seeing another protector. What did they do? Avashaha.
அவஷாஹா தேவ முனி ஷாப தேஜசா பிரவிஷ்ய ஹிருதயானி பிரக்ஷோப்ய மானாஹ ஸ்தப்தா இவ முக்தா இவ துக்தா இவ விஷானலைஹி திக்தா இவ மோகனச்சூர்ணைஹி லுப்தா லுப்தாஹ பரம் ஜீவிதேஷு லுப்தாமபி ஜெயஸ்ரியம் சிராத் ஈஷத் விவேக சுனியந்திரேண க்ஷணிக துர்மந்திரேண துர்மந்திரணேன விநாசயந்தஹ
விநாசயந்தஹ தே க்ஷணிக துர்மந்திரணேன விநாசயந்தஹ, தே வர் பீயிங் டெஸ்ட்ராய்ட் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் எ மொமெண்டரி லாப்ஸ் இன் தேர் இன்டெலிஜென்ஸ் ஆர் மொமெண்டரி லாப்ஸ் ஆஃப் தட் விவேக டிஸ்கிரிமினேட்டிங் பவர், பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் தட் தே வர் கெட்டிங் டெஸ்ட்ராய். அவஷாக வஷா மீன்ஸ் கண்ட்ரோல். ஹியர் தே ஆர் நாட் இன் கண்ட்ரோல் ஆஃப் தெம் செல்ஸ். ஸோ அவஷாக கேன் ஆல்சோ பி தட் தே ஆர் ஸ்வாயத்தா, தே ஆர் நாட் பராதீன. ஃபார் தேட் ஆல்சோ யூ கேன் யூஸ் அவஷா. தே ஆர் நாட் டிபெண்டன்ட் ஆன் அதர்ஸ். ஃபார் தேட் யூ கேன் யூஸ் அவஷா. ஹியர் இன் திஸ் சென்ஸ், இன் திஸ் கான்டெக்ஸ்ட், இட் மீன்ஸ் வசம் ஸ்வவசம் ந இதி அவஷாக. So they were not they were not in control of themselves. Deva muni shapa tejasa hridayani pravishya prakshobhyamanaha. They seemed as if the sages shapa had entered their hearts. Deva muni shapa tejasa, by the brilliance of that shapa or that tejas, that prakasham had entered into their hridaya. ஹிருதயானி பிரவிஷ்ய பிரக்ஷோப்யமானாஹ, தே வர் பீங் அஜிடேட்டட் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் தட், பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் த ஷாப தேஜஸ் என்டரிங் தேர் மைண்ட்ஸ். பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் பீங் அஜிடேட்டட் வித் தட், ஸ்தப்தா இவ, தே வர் அஸ் இஃப் நாட் மூவிங், ஸ்தப்தா நிஷ்சலா, முக்தா இவ ஃபூல்ஸ், மூடாஹ இவ, விஷ அனலைஹி தக்தாஹ இவ. இஃப் யூ ஆர் பர்ன்ட் பை பாய்சன் ஃபயர், விஷ அனலைஹி தக்தாஹ இவ, ஆஸ் இஃப் தேர் பீங் பர்ன்ட் பை பாய்சன் ஃபயர். மோகன சூர்ணைஹி, யூ நோ த மெஜிஷியன்ஸ் சம்டைம்ஸ் அப்பேரண்ட்லி யூஸ் பவுடர் டு த்ரோ அண்ட் டு மேக் தெம் ஃபெயிண்ட், ஆர் லைக் அ ஃபெயிண்டிங் பவுடர். மோகன சூர்ணைஹி திக்தா இவ, ஆஸ் இஃப் தேர் பீங் கவர்ட் பை தட். And so they will be cheated, or when the magician shows some shows, he will just throw that powder, and that powder will immediately make them see what the magician wants them to see. That is called a mohana churna. Digdhaha iva, as if being anointed by that powder. Look param, but jeeviteshu param lubdhaha. But they were very eager to hold on to their lives. Lubdhaha, greedy. Labdaha, attaining. Praptaha, lubdaha means he's greedy to get something. So jeeviteshu, as far as their lives were concerned, param lubdaha, they were extremely greedy to hold on to their lives. Labdham api jayashriyam chirat ishat viveka suniyantranena labdham api jayashriyam. So ishat, at some point they had a slight viveka. Viveka is kartavya akartavya, the difference between the kartavya and akartavya, a discriminating power. So niyantranena, by using that discriminating power in a proper manner, so niyantranena sushtu prakarena ishate viveka upayogat chirat labdhamapi jayashriyam. What did they do? Kshanika durmantranena, by just a momentary lapse of viveka, that discrimination, right? Because of that momentary lapse, vinashayantaha, they were getting destroyed. Vibhuda bataha, everything is again going to vibhuda bataha. Next.
Ashyantaha api achakshushu achakshushaha shrunvantaha api badhiraha janantaha api jadaha parigrihita iva duryashasa பரிஷ்வக்த இவ பாக்ய விபர்ய விபர்யேன விஸ்மிருத்ய குலசீலானி விசிருஜ்ய நிஷேஷம் அபத்ரப்பாம் அவரோப்ய நிஷங்கம் ஆவேஷயந்தஹ பிருஷ்டதஹ புத்திம் அவமுச்ய ஜயாயுதானி ஆததானாஹ பிக்ஷா கபாலானி பாணிபிஹி ஆசர்காத் ஆச மகாப்ரளயாத் அத்வர ஹவிர்பிஹி ஏவ த்விஜன்மனாம் அவிஷ்ராந்த பரிபுஷ்டதயா இவ ப்ராப்தே சமரே சாயுதாஷ்ச சவாஹனாஷ்ச சைகதா இவ சேதவஹ சர்வதோபி விஜகடிரே விஜகடிரே விபுத பட்டாஹ.
விபுத பட்டாஹ சர்வதஹ அபி எவ்ரிவேர் விஜகடிரே Adhavan, they just ran. Vijagatire. That is, if you are in a group, you just get shattered and move away, right? That is Vijagata. Ghatate is you join Vigata Ghatana. So they just moved apart. Pashyantaha api achakshushaha. These are all Virodhabhasa Alankara. The next three is Pashyantaha api achakshushaha, Shrunvantaha api badiraha, Janantaha api jadaha. So Pashyantaha api, even though they are using their chakshurindriya and seeing, they are using their eyes and seeing, they behave as if they don't have any eyes. Achakshushaha iva. So even if they are seeing, they don't have eyes. What does that mean? Then there is a Virodha there. It means that even if they are using their eyes to see, they are not understanding the particularity of each object that they are seeing. I might just look at an object and not understand what it is, right? Kinchit, yet kinchit idam is the just understanding that they see. Or they are so engrossed and they're so defeated and upset that even if they have blank looks in their eyes, they might be seeing, but they are not understanding, or the jnana vishayam na bhavati. Shrunvantaha api, the same goes for this also. Even if they are listening, they are as if they are not able to listen. Badiraha iva. Janantaha api jadaha. Even though they know, jnana ashrayaha api jnana anashrayaha. Jadaha is a person who does not have any intelligence. Even if they understand things, they behave as if they don't understand. So it means they only know what it is, but they don't know the particularity. In the sense, this is something, they don't know that this is a ghatam, or this is a table, this is a book. Pustakatvam iti vishesham na grinthanti. Then parishvakta parigrihita iva duryashasa. As if they have been caught by ill fame, duryashas. Parishvaktaha alingitaha bhagya viparyayena, by the change of fortune. It was as if they were being hugged by the change of fortune. Bhagyasya viparyayena alingitaha iva kula shilani vismritya. They forgot their ancestry, the shilam, the character of their whole entire family. Whose sons they are brihaspati, shakshat brahma putraha. They've been created by Brahma. They've forgotten their ancestry and their character. Vismritya. Nishesham apatrapam visrijya. Trapa, apatrapa again is. Trapa is also shame. Apatrapa can also mean shame. Apatrapa also means, you know, that lajja, one who is devoid of shame. That also it can mean. Okay. Here, because we know the status and the context of devas, we are talking about apatrapa means lajja. Apagata trapa or anye apahaseyuhu iti trapa. That is lajja. Trapa is also krihi lajja. So others might ridicule us. Tadrisha trapam visrijya. See, if you in a battle, if you leave the battle and run away, people are going to call you coward. Aren't you ashamed? People will ridicule you. That sort of a shame also left them. So they let go of that lajja, nishesham, without any reminder. Completely they were without any lajja. Nishangam avaropya, removed their nishanga, quiver. Buddhim prishtataha aveshayantaha, they pushed their intelligence behind. They did not think about whether they should be doing this or not. They just left their thinking behind. And then what did they do? Ayudhani. Jaya Ayudhani. Avamuchya Jaya Ayudhani. They let go of the weapons that gave them victory till now. Whatever weapons they were using to attain victory, Jaya Ayudha, Tani, Avamuchya, Utsrijya. Bhiksha kapalani pani bihi, with their hands, bhiksha kapalani adadanaha, they took the begging bowls. Asarkat, acha mahapralayat, mahapralayat cha. As if from their birth until the mahapralaya, they have only been living from the havir bihi, havis that they get from dvijanmanam அவிஷ்ராந்த பரிபுஷ்டதையா துஜன்மனாம் அத்வரஹவிர்பிஹி ஏவ தோஸ் பிராமன்ஸ் ஹூ ஹெட் பீன் கிவிங் கான்ஸ்டன்ட்லி இன் த அத்வர அத்வர இஸ் யாக ஹவிஹி ஆப்லேஷன் சோ இட்ஸ் ஆஸ் இஃப் தே ஹவ் ஓன்லி லிவ்ட் ஆர் தே ஹவ் பீன் நர்ச்சர்ட் பரிபுஷ்டதையா தே ஹவ் பீன் கான்ஸ்டன்ட்லி நர்ச்சர்ட் விதவுட் எனி ஸ்பேஸ் அவிஷ்ராந்த பரிபுஷ்டதையா இவ ஆஸ் இஃப் தே ஹவ் பீன் நர்ச்சர்ட் கான்ஸ்டன்ட்லி ஓன்லி பை த பிராமின்ஸ் அத்வர ஹவிர்பிஹி the oblation, the sacred oblation that they put in the Homa food, they have been, it is as if they were like that. They took the Bhiksha Patram and went. It's connected with that. A sargat from the A janmanat, A srishtehe, A cha mahapralayat until pralaya, they have only been nurtured by this. So thinking, they took the begging bowls. And then prapte samare, only when such a fight happens, when the battle came alone, sayudaha cha sa vahanaha cha, until then they don't have any ayudha nor do they have any vahanas. It is as if only during that battle time they took up all the weapons and vahanas and everything. Until then they only had bhiksha patram. That is their natural state of life. It was as if like that, all utpreksha here. சைகதா இவ சேதவஹா ஓ பியூட்டிஃபுல் உபமா தட் ஹி கிவ்ஸ் ஹியர் வேர் சர்வதா எவ்ரிவேர் தி ஜஸ்ட் டிசப்பியர்ட் ஆஸ் இஃப் லைக் சைகதா சேதவஹா இவ லைக் த சைகதம் இஸ் சாண்ட் சேது இஸ் பிரிட்ஜ் லைக் பிரிட்ஜ் இஸ் மேட் ஆஃப் சாண்ட் தே ஜஸ்ட் டிசப்பியர்ட் எவ்ரிவேர் சர்வதா ஸோ இஃப் தேர் இஸ் ராம சேது connecting between Lanka and India, you will find just small blocks of sand here and there. But during low tide, you could actually walk at some point. Now it's all gone down. The sand has been eroded so much. But at some point, you could actually walk from Dhanushkoti to Lanka. The sand was there. Now, but it is when the high tide comes, it just goes off, right? Now you only see pockets of sand. That's how they disappeared. It's a saikataha iva setavaha, just like bridges made of sand, everywhere the vibhuda bataha, the deva soldiers just spread vijagatire. Okay, ghatate is coming together and vijagatate, vighatate is moving apart. They just moved apart, not knowing what.
So this is all the karma devaha and the ajana devaha.
Here it is only about Ajana Devaha, this entire paragraph. So that's why we started off with Apasarataha Karma Devana Pashyantaha.
Oh, okay.
They looked at the Karma Deva moving away, the Daitya Devas killing everybody, and they looked at the Senapati, even their own Lord Indra standing still without doing anything. And they saw that they did not apashyantaha trataram. They did not think that there were any protector for them. And so they let go of their weapons and took up bhiksha patra. Exactly. The contrast that he shows is what I like. The way he describes Amaravati in the beginning and the way they behave here. Very beautiful contrast.
So how come he did not describe Indra here? I mean, there's no mention. Indra at all.
That will come next. He will describe okay. Indra and what he was thinking. Why did I make such a mistake in my life? He will start.
Oh, okay.
That is, of course, without the mental state of the Lord, how can it be complete, right? Yeah. If Lakshmi can think about it, Neelakanta Dikshita can think about it.
Yeah. So in the battlefield though he did not show any he did not show the valor of Indra. He showed the valor of all the devas.
Yes.
But not of Indra's.
No, Indra's was just as he is a nayaka, right? So he will only give instructions. So he asked in the beginning, you will see the Sena Sannivesha, he asked each one of them to stand at each position, right, and divided the divisions. That is his work. But he was standing at the Sena Mukha.
Okay.
His prowess is not shown here. Even before that, they saw the Akramanam of Asuras and they saw that they could win. Asuras could win. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll stop with this, huh? Yeah.